Hey guys, Brady here with your daily tennis lesson. Coming at you today with a rumor that I kind of want to dispel, or a myth, so to speak, that I want to kind of clear up. And that's the idea of getting your racket back really early. And I think the reason a lot of you guys, whether you take lessons or not, are hearing get your racket back really early is simply the vocabulary of it. A lot of tennis coaches, when they were younger, were taught to simply take the racket back low. And there was no loop in a lot of forehands, even up to 15 years ago. So the fact that a lot of coaches teach a loop now, the vocabulary really hasn't changed. They're still coaching get your racket back. So the myth I want to dispel is that, you know, we need to think more about setting the racket and leaving it in this set position up until it's time to swing, versus setting it and getting it dropped too early, okay? Because this has no continuity to it. When you guys get this loop set and dropped right after the opponent hits the ball, we've become stagnant here, and we're waiting for the ball to come from this position. And this is not a current position to start hitting from. We want to be taking momentum off the drop of your loop into contact. So what I'm going to do is back up and show you guys one swing to start with, where right when Mark hits the ball, I'm going to go past this set position and immediately get it dropped down. And again, this is the rumor here. This is me getting my racket back really early. And it's not a great thing, because as I wait in this position, like I said, it's almost a hitch at this point. There's a break in the ability to carry momentum through to the ball. All right, so Mark will feed the first one in. I'll be way too early with my drop from the loop. And you guys can see it's just a much stiffer swing. Let's look at that one more time. You know, it's a shot I can make if the ball's not too tough, but that's definitely not a modern forehand, which again is our main goal, you know, from the lowest levels of tennis to the highest levels. Let's swing the way the current pros swing. So now it's the right way. Now I focus more on setting the racket and leaving it in the set position, not the drop position or the back position, so to speak. I'd leave it in the set position until I'm ready to swing, and that's when it all comes together. Here we go. You guys can see how much more fluid that is when I wait until the ball is almost bouncing before I start that drop. And now I've got all this momentum coming into contact. Okay, so first and foremost, I don't want you guys taking the racket straight back. This is something that had its time back in the 70s and 80s. We're not hitting the ball this way anymore, where we take the racket straight back. And on top of that, if you hear somebody say, get your racket back right away, I want you to just assume that they are talking about setting your racket, but leaving it in the set position up until it's time to go hit the ball, so we have that nice fluid motion of the modern forehand. Okay, so that's all I got for you guys today. Hope that was helpful. Please click like below this video, and if you happen to be watching on YouTube, please subscribe to our channel. Thanks, and we'll see you guys soon.